The Northern Lights are something we have on Earth, but it's also visible on other planets. Yeah, other planets have aurora as well. Neptune has aurora. Actually, it's recently discovered that Mars is not viable at the moment because it doesn't have an atmosphere, but it does have a magnetic field. And its magnetic field is centered on its poles. So you have aurora on Mars, it's just in one spot on the North Pole. It's not surrounded around the Earth like it is here. Yeah? Europa, the moon of Jupiter, I believe, the biggest moon, it has lights as well, it has aurora as well. Yeah? So the aurora on Neptune is purple. Yeah, because it depends on which gas gets affected by the solar activity. Yeah? So as we have oxygen, nitrogen, creating green and pink, there is a different gas that creates purple. There's also, so the Northern Lights themselves is something that we see created on Earth in our daily lives. Everyone has seen the same reaction as we see when we see the Northern Lights. A neon light. A neon light is a glass tube with a gas in it, and electricity is running through, exciting the gas and lighting it up, creating light. A green neon light is oxygen. Yeah. That's quite cool, I think. And so we call the aurora nature's advertisement. Yeah. Now, of course, the Northern Lights have existed for a long time, and it's only in the 1860s that we have started to correlate Northern Lights with solar activity. Before that, there was a lot of different ways that the Northern Lights were, you know, people were trying to create an explanation. Yeah, without science around, it's pretty difficult to create an explanation. So people started to create stories. And a lot of stories got created, and a really popular one of the stories is from Norwegian fishing villages. Around the coasts of Norway, the Northern Lights are seen quite often. And what they would say is that the Northern Lights are a big group of fish in the fjord, and the moonlight is reflecting on their scales, shining up into the sky. Yeah. In a lot of cultures, the Northern Lights are correlated with the souls of our ancestors. And their presence in the sky is creating this magical light. And they want to tell us something. They want to give us inspiration and show us the way to go in life. That's a really cool one too. And there's many stories, and Tegan has a lot of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go for it.
I keep book on these legends because I think they're very interesting. Because there's so many, especially here in the Northern Hemisphere. Not just only in Scandinavia, but even around on North America, they have their own versions of what they believe the Northern Lights were. So I think my favorite one is the Finnish legend, and I think it's a very, very beautiful story. And how they tell it is, they said that one day it was full moon, and the full moon came down onto the earth, onto the Scandinavian Arctic tundra in Lapland. Right. And the Arctic animals, they noticed, but why is the moon coming down to Earth? This is so strange, the moon is supposed to be up in the sky, right? So all the Arctic animals, they gathered to hear what the moon had to say. And the moon said, well, I need some help lighting up the sky when I go to rest. You know how the moon has phases, it has full moon, and it goes into new moon when there's no moon in the sky, right? So it said, I needed help lighting up the sky when I go into new moon. And so the Arctic animals asked, but then how can we help you? And the moon said, well, here's an idea. Why don't you guys become stars? And so the Arctic animals thought this was really strange. How can we become a star? And the moon then showed them the way up into the sky. And what they did is they then started walking, starting making their way up the sky. So the Arctic bear, you know, like the Big Dipper we have? So the Arctic bear and the reindeer, the moose, even the fish, they all went up to the sky to form constellations that we see. And so what happened was there's this little fox, it's a little bit late to the party, And he came and he started running up into the sky and realized that he couldn't become a star. And so he asked the moon, but moon, why can't I become a star? And so the moon said, well, you don't necessarily have to become a star to light up the sky. Why don't you go for a run? Run across the mountains and get your friends, being the other Arctic fox. And so the little Arctic fox has started running and they're picking up speed, and as it was running, it's running so fast that this big bushy tail was whipping off snowflakes and sparks into the sky, and these sparks in the sky were shooting up northern lights into the sky. And so the Finnish believe that is the little red Arctic fox that has caused the northern lights. And so the Finnish name for northern lights is called Revontulet, which directly translates to fox flames. And so that's the story of the Finnish.